Welcome to the video lecture series of Satellite Communication. Today I will discuss AKTU examination question paper and solution. This examination was held in session 2019-20 and it is actually based on multiple choice questions. So the subject is satellite and radar systems. Its code is REC083. In this subject, there are two parts actually. One is the satellite and second is the radar. So first, in this particular lecture, I will discuss the multiple choice questions based on satellite communications. Let us begin. First question is, the satellite that is used as a relay to extend communication distance is called as. See, when the earth stations cannot communicate directly because of the line of sight restrictions, then satellite is used, and that type of communication is known as communication satellite. It means B is the correct answer. Question number 2 is, the transmitter receiver combination. Read the question carefully. The transmitter receiver combination in the satellite is known as, this is nothing but the transponder. Means C is the correct answer. Question number 3 is, which technique uses two different antennas to reduce traffic on the same frequency? Read all the options given over here very carefully. Is it spatial isolation, frequency reuse, multiplexing or modulation? So, frequency reuse is the technique which uses two different antennas to reduce traffic on the same frequency. Means B is the correct answer. Question number 4 is, which of the following is not a satellite subsystem? Options are ground station, power supply, telemetry tracking, communication subsystem. When you read all the options given here carefully, you will be able to find out that power system, telemetry tracking and communication subsystems are the part of satellite subsystem. It means ground station is the odd one out. This is not a part of satellite subsystem. Means A is the correct answer. Question number 5 is, when the speed of satellite maximum in an elliptical orbit, what is that particular point? Options are retrograde, posigrade, perigee and apogee. If you realize and if you recall whatever you have studied in the case of the satellite communication, you can recall that the speed of satellite is greater whenever it is closer to the earth, and the closest point is known as the perigee. It means answer is C, correct one. Question number 6 is, what is the angle of inclination for a satellite following in an equatorial orbit? And options are given as apogee angle, LOS angle, angle of elevation and angle of inclination. But in my opinion, this question is incomplete somewhere. See, you are also aware that the angle of inclination for a satellite which follows an equatorial orbit, this is what? 0 degree. When the orbit of a satellite and Earth's equator are aligned, inclination is 0 degree, then only it will follow. But the option is not given over here. So I think this is the incomplete question. Question number 7 is, what percentage of the earth can communication satellite see? Options are 50, 20, 40, 70. So 40% of the earth can communication satellite see. Means answer is this, C, correct one. Question number 8 is, why there is a huge spectrum space between the transmitted and received signal in the satellite communication? Why this spectrum space is very large? Options are maximum efficiency, reduce interference, less attenuation and to reduce space occupied by filters. See, In satellite communication, you have studied that transmitter and receiver in satellite transponder is designed to operate at separate frequency. And in this particular way, they do not interfere with each other. It means the purpose is to reduce interference. B is the correct answer. Question number 9 is, the time period taken by the satellite to complete one orbit is called. You can pick this answer very quickly. It is sidereal period. Correct one. Question number 10 is, which of the following is not true? You have to pick the false option. Let us read one by one all the options. First is, battery is only used as a backup. This is correct. Next is, when in orbit, solar power is always available. This is not true. See, in case of some unfavorable atmospheric condition, when solar power is not available, battery is used. So, B is not a true option. But let us see what the other two options are also given. Next is, battery is used for initial satellite orientation and stabilization. This is absolutely perfect. Last is, the batteries are charged using solar power, which is also true. It means B is the option which is not true over here. So, answer is B. Question number 11 is, which of the following bands cannot be used for satellite communication? Options are given as medium frequency, Ku band, X band and C band. Out of these four, medium frequency band is the lower frequency band and it does not lie in the microwave spectrum. While you know that microwaves are used in satellite communication because lower bands get reflected by ionosphere, it means answer is A. Question number 12 is, which of the following is not a part of propulsion subsystem? AKM, jet thruster, gyroscope and fuel control system. Out of these four options, gyroscopes, and you know that it comes under the heading of attitude control subsystem, means gyroscope is not a part of propulsion subsystem. Correct answer. Question number 13 is, why it is not possible to provide transmit function by wideband amplifier and mixer circuits? What could be the reason? Options are heavy attenuation, high power output, over wideband is not possible, economically not profitable, weight of the system increases fivefold. See, this happens because no such components or circuit can do it nicely for high power output over the wideband. Means high power output over wideband is quite difficult. It means answer is B. Correct one. Question number 14 is, in RF tuning, what is the first local oscillator? See, in RF tuning, first local oscillator is made adjustable and frequency synthesizer generates a very stable signal at selected frequency increments. It means B must be the answer. Let us check. Yes, it is. Question number 15 is, if the Earth station downlink signal receives at FS is equal to 4.08 GHz, what first stage local oscillator frequency FLO you need to calculate to achieve IF of 770 MHz? You know the formula. What is FIF, intermediate frequency? This is what? F of S minus F of LO. And you need to calculate F of LO. So this would be what? F of S minus F of intermediate frequency. What is FS given? FS is 4.08 GHz, other in the megahertz. Let us convert into the same scale. Let us say this is 4080 megahertz minus 770 megahertz. So this is coming as what? 3310 megahertz. Let us find the correct answer. This is A. Yes, it is correct one. Question number 16 is, which part of the transmitter subsystem modulates the baseband signal? Options are antenna, upconverter, power amplifiers and mixers. See, upconverters translates the baseband signals modulated onto carrier up to the final uplink. Microwave frequencies, it means answer is B. Correct one. Question number 17 is, when individual upconverters are used to modulate a channel, what is used to combine them into final stage? See, when individual upconverters are used to modulate a channel, then to combine it, microwave combiner is used. And actually the output of this microwave combiner is fed to the final amplifier. It means answer is A. Correct one. Question number 18 is, which frequency band does the direct broadcast satellite system use? DBS system uses which frequency band? You can pick the answer very quickly. It is KU band. In KU band, what is the like range of frequencies? 14 to 14.5 for the uplink and 10.15 approximately to 12.75 for the downlink. Answer is C. Question number 19 is, what is the number of satellites present in Iridium system? See, Iridium system uses a constellation of 66 satellites in 6 polar orbits with 11 satellites per orbit. Means answer is C, 66. Correct one. Question number 20 is, which of the following is not a reason for redistributing TV signals through satellite rather than sky waves or space waves? Read all the options: high frequency signal, long distance communication, economically feasible and power requirements. So the correct option is power requirement. Power requirement is not a reason for redistributing TV signals, because all the three options, they are actually the reasons. Answer is correct. Question number 21 is, which of the following are common baseband signal transmitted from Earth ground station? Read all the options: navigation data, computer data, video. Second is computer data, navigation data, voice. Third is voice, video, computer data. And fourth is the computer data. So the three most common baseband signals are actually voice, video and computer data. C is the correct answer. Question number 22 is, why are VHF, UHF and microwave signals used in satellite communication? These signals are used because they penetrate the ionosphere with small or almost no attenuation, and they are not refracted to the earth. So answer is C. Correct one. Question number 23 is, what is the reason for shifting from C band to KU band in satellite communication? The reason is overcrowding, because many communication satellites are in the orbit now and most of them in the C band. So now it has been shifted towards the KU band. So reason is overcrowding. B is the correct answer. Question number 24 is, as the height of satellite orbit gets lower, the speed of satellite, you know that the formula, velocity of a satellite, you can write it as under root g into m upon r. So from this formula you can see velocity is proportional to the 1 upon under root r. It means if v decreases, r means if height of satellite orbit gets slower. Means if r decreases, velocity will increase. Answer is A. Question number 25. The radiation pattern of earth coverage antenna have a beam width of approximately, it's 17 degree. Next question. The frequency of Ku band for satellite communication. Read all the options. You must have attempted this question number of times. For uplink, it's 14 gigahertz. For downlink, it's 11. So the answer is 14 by 11. Correct one. Question number 27 is, the earth area covered by the satellite radio beam. Earth area covered by a satellite radio beam is known as footprint. Let us check the answer. Correct one. Question number 28 is, which deflects the satellite signal relayed from the feed and converts it to an electric current, amplifies and lowers its frequency. Options are horn antenna, low noise amplifier, satellite receiver and satellite dish. Out of these four, low noise amplifier actually detects the satellite signal relayed from the feed, then convert it, amplifies and lowers the frequency. Means answer is B. Correct one. Question number 29 is, what kind of battery panels are used in some advanced satellites? Battery panels which are used in advanced satellites is gallium arsenide solar panel array. This kind of panels are actually to be used in the future space missions also. Answer is D. Question number 30 is, a helical antenna is used for satellite tracking because, see, in case of helical antenna, diameter and pitch of the helix are comparable to the wavelength and it radiates circularly polarized radio waves. Means A is the correct answer. Question number 31 is, the most common device used as an low noise amplifier is, whether it is a Zener diode, tunnel diode, impact diode or Shockley diode. See, low noise amplifier must provide a relatively flat response for a frequency range of our interest, and tunnel diode is actually a diode which is highly sensitive and low noise device. It means the commonly used device as a low noise amplifier is tunnel diode. Answer is B. Question number 32. The three axes referred to the three axes attitude stabilized are, except three axes are what? Pitch, roll and yaw. So answer is D over here. Correct one. Question number 33 is, it is a position and timing service that is available to all GPS users on a continuous worldwide basis with no direct charge. What is that service? PPI, PPS, SPS and SSP. It's a SPS service. Correct one. Question number 34 is, it is caused by the inertia of the satellite balanced by the Earth's gravitational pull. What is that? Is it centrifugal force, centripetal force, speed or Earth's rotation? So centripetal force actually caused by the inertia of the satellite and which actually balance the Earth's gravitational pull. It means B is the correct answer. Question number 35 is, what is the reason for carrying multiple transponders in a satellite? Why multiple transponders are carried in the case of the satellite? It is because to be economically feasible, satellite must be capable of handling several channels. Therefore, multiple transponders are carried and each and every transponder represents an individual communication channel. So, what you are going to pick as a correct answer? More number of operating channels. This is correct one. Question number 36 is, why does the orbit take the shape of an ellipse or circle? See, circle and ellipse are geometrical figure that can be accurately described mathematically. You have studied it as well. And in this case, it is possible to calculate position of satellite at any instant of time. It means position can be easily determined. Answer must be A. Question number 37. Which frequency band is used for connecting satellite system with the public switch telephone network? Which frequency band is used for PSTN? KA band is actually used for the PSTN services where satellite system is being connected over there. So KA band, answer is D. Correct one. Question number 38 is, in GPS, it is accomplished by manipulating navigation message orbital data and or the satellite clock frequency. What is this? Is it a selective availability, reverse error notification, forward error notification or two-dimensional reporting? This is actually the selective availability. Answer is A. Correct one. Next question is, Kepler's second law is known as. Recall the Kepler's second law. Kepler's second law states that planets sweeps out equal areas in equal time interval. It means it is the law of areas. Correct one. So these are the questions based on satellite communication which have been asked in the university examination. Remaining questions are related to the radar systems. So all those questions have been covered in a separate video. Thank you so much for watching this video.